Yes. Okay, great. Yeah, thank you for giving me the opportunity to pitch my research. So my name is Stefan Klein. I'm an associate professor in the group, and I'm leading a research line on, it's called image registration and radiomics, but it's the topics that I'm working on are pretty broad. So in general, the focus of my research is exactly as Vera already showed, extracting more information out of medical images. For example, extract quantitative measurements, to do automatic segmentations and compute the volume of a structure, to develop models of anatomy, of healthy anatomy versus diseased anatomy, and really also to go directly from an image to a probable diagnosis, or to say something about biological characteristics of a tumor, for example. Or just to create nice visualizations. I think it's also an interesting topic. For this research, we use a lot of machine learning techniques. I think most of you will be somehow familiar with it. The concept of machine learning is typically that we collect a lot of training data, a lot of representative images, which are labeled according to the thing that we want to predict. So in this case, we have squares and circles that in this case represent two types of tumors in the brain that we want to distinguish based on the MRI appearance. So what we do is we collect a lot of data, then we train a model, a machine learning technique, and there's a lot of variation in models that you can use there and techniques that learns how to distinguish the two classes. And then for a new example, this model can predict whether it was a square or a circle. This approach, you see, it's always the same what you need in all applications. First, you need a lot of data, and then you need some tools to train models, etc. And then you have to test that on another large set of data to see how well your predictions are, how good your predictions are. So to streamline that kind of analysis, we have developed an open source toolbox for this kind of radiomics studies, as we call it. It's called WORK, and you can also check here the description online. And that really takes a researcher through the whole process of collecting data, annotating it, computing quantitative features on this data, and then fitting machine learning models. And then actually even automatically it compares many different models and takes the best one, and then gives you an estimate of how well it performs. So this was work by Martijn Staarmans, who also proposed some projects. This toolbox we have used a lot in a lot of collaborations within the hospital, but also outside the hospital. And especially, it's a very efficient and fast approach. Recently, we have developed another framework. This was developed by Sebastian van der Voort. It's another PhD student in my group who are now a postdoc, who also is going to propose some projects. He developed somewhat similar framework, but based on deep learning technology. So, which is really optimal if you have really large data sets, whereas the previous framework also works if you have a bit smaller data sets. So he worked on prediction of different brain tumor characteristics and developed a quite very nice comprehensive framework that which also allows you to test different deep learning models and see what is the best approach for doing either segmentation or predicting some genetic characteristics of these tumors with a few lines of code and run that on a large supercomputer. So also with this framework, I think we will streamline our research in this field, because there's so many applications where this kind of machine learning techniques are useful that I don't want to start from scratch in every project. I selected a few publications from recent work in good journals where we use these softwares for studies on different types of tumors, for example. So here are three examples from Martijn Staarmans, who on different types of tumors, actually distinguishing them. Here's three works by Sebastian van der Voort using his deep learning frameworks. One funny one was, so there's two examples here of where we predict different tumors, but it also one example where we used a deep learning framework to recognize skin types. Final one application on osteoarthritis prediction. So the final slide, we have several projects that we propose. So Martijn Starmans proposes two projects using radiomics to apply to one on colorectal liver metastasis and another one on prediction of hypertrophic cardiomyopathy based on MRI scans. Then Sebastian van der Voort, together with Karen van Gaarderen, is proposing three projects, all focused on use of deep learning applied to brain tumor MRI. And then finally, Yuka Hervas-Nimi is a postdoc who's actually going to work on a convergence project, so this collaboration between Delft and Erasmus MC, on prediction of osteoarthritis. So, and he proposes several projects on deep learning for musculoskeletal image analysis, which is also really, like, I think an underestimated topic, because like a million people in the Netherlands have osteoarthritis, so it's a really a big disease. This is my pitch. I hope you find it somewhat inspiring, and feel free to contact these people in the later chat rooms.